What's taking shape here is not just a new cane farm, it's also a lifelong dream for brothers Joe and Jared Grottelli to follow their father Enzo into the farming business. And this tractor hauling a laser bucket is using GPS technology to carve out success for the next generation at Abergowrie. It's a capital and labour-intensive effort, but the long-term rewards should be worth the substantial investment as these Ingham District farmers work to restore 202 hectares of failed tree plantation land to sugarcane production. The long-term objective is to set the paddocks up for minimal till farming, using laser levelling to improve drainage and also limit the potential for herbicide, nutrient and sediment runoff into the Great Barrier Reef catchment. The process begins by surveying the block, enlisting the expertise of the local team at the Herbert River Cane Productivity Services.
Because this was under trees, they had slightly different row directions and shorter rows, and Joe wanted to make the rows as long as possible, so we just took a survey and tried to maximise the row length and get enough fall down the drill for the water to run off. That's the main reason we came here.
We then go back to the computer. We look at the computer based on the drill length that we want, the direction that we want, see if it's attainable at a reasonable cost. We do that. And then we get our contract ASM Earth moving. They come out and we, together with HCPSL, work out the best way to laser the block. We then carry out the laser levelling. We go through, we rip it conventionally because we don't want to leave any sticks in the ground. We want to make sure we get everything out of the ground so that there's no residual stumps or anything for future problems if we hit them with a planter or something like that. So we can't do any zonal in this instance because we want to make sure that we got the ground clean underneath for the future. Once this is planted conventionally this time, then from then on we will go to a zonal system and that's how it'll be farmed.
With the Lucinda bulk sugar terminal at Ingham's back door, the Grottelli brothers are acutely aware of the connection between their farmland and the World Heritage listed Great Barrier Reef. That's why they've made a point of accessing the Australian Government Reef Programme, formerly known as Reef Rescue, to co-fund several projects that will improve the quality of the water leaving their farms.
We purchased a zonal hoe and a GPS in our first application. That was to give us the ability to go zonal, to do minimum till and to do continuous traffic. We then applied for a fertiliser box. All this area in the Abergowrie area, we have to use Comfidor because we have a big problem with grubs. So we actually also put a Comfidor applicator onto our stool splitter fertiliser box that we got through Reef Rescue, and that gave us the ability to do one pass Comfidor and fertiliser applications underneath the ground, and saves us a lot of time. The next thing we did was we applied for shielded sprayers. That gave us the ability to use Roundup in a lot of cases rather than use residuals, so we could spray in a row, knocking the grass down without actually using residuals, and being able to use Roundup without knocking the cane down. So we've purchased about 500 acres of tree land altogether. This section here that we're doing now, that was the last 140 acres. We bought that in October last year. We purchased all this land basically looking like that. It's got the trees on it, was failed MIS, was all gone into receivership. We've done tenders for most of it. This property here was purchased after the tenders, so this here was just bought outright.
The few remaining rows of barely recognisable teak saplings paint a bleak picture of one of Australia's most costly crop failures. The trees were planted on former cane land that was purchased by the now defunct Great Southern Managed Investment Company. This district lost 10% of its cane production to the MIS developments. But in a story that's being repeated all over the north, thousands of hectares of these run-down plantations are being returned and giving younger growers in particular a chance to gain a foothold in the industry.
The MIS trees, all the land was originally cane. Once that went to MIS, it wasn't looked after properly. It was left to overgrow and be run down. And so when that failed, there was obviously a lot of people looked into taking it back over, but there's a fair bit of cost involved in getting it back from what they had done to it to get it back to cane again.
Restoring tree plantation land to cane production is a time-consuming and costly process. First, the trees had to be cleared and the block thoroughly disc-ploughed before being reshaped and, where required, laser-levelled.
We probably attacked all this with a dozer first, knocked it down when it was wet. We couldn't do this in October last year when we bought it because it was too dry. So we went through in February, March this year. We started when it was wet, walked through with the dozer, probably had the blade about 8 inches off the ground, walked through, knocked them all down. Then we got a 20-foot rake on the dozer. We go 90 degrees to the direction that we knocked them down, and we rake them across, stacked them either against the creek bank or we made stacks, and those stacks will be burnt later. The ones that we don't burn, we leave them stacked against the creek bank. We'll leave them there. They'll reinforce the bank and they'll just decay along the bank in time and stay like that, and there's no need to burn them or anything like that. Obviously now all of it's gone back to cane, and that was a desperately needed thing for the local economy, because without the turnover from sugarcane, our town can't survive, because that's basically all we do here in Ingham is sugar, a little bit of cattle, but mainly sugar.
And that's why Ingham District cane growers, like the Grottelli family, are taking a sustainable approach to farming, protecting the reef and their local economy for generations to follow.